What is good, y'all? Yeah, it's your boy Cabby Joe, aka O'Really, man. And in today's video, I'm coming at y'all with another how to get y'all shooting badges, man. I did this video last year, it did pretty well. I have a lot of friends who need their badges for real, so that's why I'm making this video. And if you need your badges done, just honestly, just do this. Your shooting badges, this for shooting badges only, honestly. Because playmaking badges, you get it by throwing lobs in park, and you could do the playing glitch too. But shooting badges is one of the hardest, well, easiest after I make this video. So, yeah, as y'all can see, I am an all-star one. I am killing the best 83 overall playmaking shot in the game, I'm not lying. But this is the amount of badges I got. Yesterday, I didn't have really much that much badges. But now we are forced to play career since you know, the courts are glitched and shit. But it's all good. I am 50% to All-Star 2, so I'm grinding for y'all. 60% to All-Star 2, actually. So I'm grinding for y'all, man. I'm trying to hit the top rep this year. So yeah, let's get into this video, man. Oh yeah, and before we get into the video, I almost forgot. You have to make sure your thing, to me, I use my meter on, and the jump shot I use is D-Wade. But game difficulty, make sure it's on pro, because it doesn't really make that big of a difference on Hall of Fame. And your shooting percentage is going to drop. And make sure you have it on 10 minutes or 7 minutes. Now, if you don't have that much VC, I'd go 7 minutes. But 10 minutes is the best. Because the reason you don't want to put on 12 minutes is because your field goal percentage drops too much. And honestly, it's not worth it. So that's why you should put on 10 minutes and why you should put it on pro. Let's get straight into the video. All right, so to start the video off, I know I am playing one of the best defenses in the game, so it is kind of, you know, I'm being kind of a hypocrite. But what you're gonna want to do, you run through the screens like that. You just literally, you use the left stick to move. You don't dribble or nothing. You literally run to the right or to the opposite side, and you literally green a shot. Now I'm gonna put it on half court trap. This is very important, because you want every possession. I am playing on 10 minute quarters. Hopefully LeBron gives me the ball. Alright, let's do it again. I could just shoot the ball right here since I have range, but I am showing you guys what I do. You see, he steps back, green, every time, literally. Now, all you need for this method is gonna be range extender gold. I did it on gold. I literally just upgraded my range to Hall of Fame, literally. Last game, I'm telling you, I get a badge every game. So I'm gonna ask for the ball again from LeBron. Could have shot the ball there too, but I'm showing you guys the method so you guys don't think I'm joking. Now you call the screen from Danny Green, green every time, bro. I'm telling you, every single time. Now I just found this method out. I just found out that it works again. They did bring it back, but yeah, all you guys need is range extender gold, man. I'm telling y'all. We are playing against one of the best defenses in the league. So yeah, I'm gonna call for the ball one more time, and you could momentum and you could do that too, but I feel like this is just gonna be way better and it's easier. You don't have to worry about, you know, nothing. Look, just run through the screen, green every time, every single time. All you need is range extender. Like, I have green machine on bronze. All you need is range extender on gold or Hall of Fame. Now look, I know he might score on me, but look, the only badges that I have is, let's see, and my three is a 94. Oh yeah, I have floor general, so my three goes up to 94. This is another reason you want to go to the Lakers, guys. They do boost up all your attributes, as you can see. But yeah, it's actually 88, but with the Lakers boost, it's 84. Look, these are the only badges I have. I do have some playmaking badges. These are the only shooting badges I have, and this is literally all you guys need. After the game, I am going to show you guys how much I did get off doing this method. This is kind of a glitch. I don't know if I'm going to put the title as a glitch, but literally the easiest way to get your shooting badges. All you have to do is grind 3 badges and get range extender on gold, and trust me, this is going to be the easiest method. Look, green every time. Well, that was my fault, you know, I timed it wrong. But yeah, you guys could also take off the meter if you guys want to. I heard it's better, but I just like to be sure and I have the meter on. You don't really want to play defense. Half court trap. Kalari. Damn, he hit that. Alright, so I'm gonna meet with you guys at the end of the video. I'm gonna show you guys how much I got. Alright guys, so that was the video, man. I basically showed you guys what to do. Now this is the game. I had to play another game because the Raptors are, their defense is amazing. And I'm not gonna lie, they had me on clamps after I did it the first few times. So what you wanna do is pick a team that is not that good. See, look at the stats. In 20 minutes, I did all that. For me, I did give Curry bucks. You don't wanna have a point guard like Kyle Lowry who, you know, is actually a good defender. So yeah. Now, I'm gonna show you guys how much mind points I have and basically what I did. See, I got 28K, 15K on a badge. It's got a badge. That's half a badge every game. So that's one badge per game or two badges per game, depending on how good you do it. Yeah, that was the video, guys. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe. About to hit this big 600. So yeah, make sure you guys turn on the post notifications. About to drop an outfit video in the next couple of days. So yeah, stay tuned for that.